The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Sahihain, in Bukhari and Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam woke up one afternoon very frightened, or very concerned, sorry. Fazi'an, like he was concerned, shocked. And he said, La ilaha illallah, out of shock. Waylun lil Arab min sharrin qad iqtarab. Woe to the Arabs from a bad thing that has come very near. Futiha al-yawma min radmi ya'juj wa ma'juj mithlu hadhi. Today, the wall of Ya'juj and Ma'juj has been opened as much as this. And he made a ring with his fingers. He said, this much has been passed through the wall of Ya'juj and Ma'juj. Then Zainab radiallahu anha said, Ya Rasulallah, afanahliku wa fina salihun. He said, will we be destroyed? And among us there are still righteous people? Yani, when he said Ya'juj and Ma'juj, it's basically saying that the end of the world has come very near. Allah is going to destroy the world. So Zainab radiallahu anha says, Ya Rasulallah, are we going to be destroyed so soon? And still among us there are righteous people. There's you, there's the Sahabas, there's all these righteous people whom Allah praised in the Quran. Qala na'am. He said, actually, yes, you can be destroyed while righteous people are among you. Idha kathura. He said, Idha kathura al-khabath. He said, if the righteous people will be destroyed among the non-righteous people, if, on one condition, when indecency and immorality spread too much. It's too much of it, Allah will destroy the people, including the righteous people among them. There are two definitions to this, or interpretations. Number one, either because the righteous people are not doing their job, or the corruption has exceeded so much that the righteous people cannot do anymore, so it's time to take them away. The test of the world is pointless. Take them, start judging them, put whoever's in heaven and whoever goes to hell, hellfire. It's pointless now to live on. So beware, my dear brothers and sisters, and continue in your da'wah. Now, what does this mean? Does that mean that Ya'juj and Ma'juj have already pecked through the wall since that time? Allahu A'lam. What it means though is that it is close. How are they breaking through? Allahu A'lam. How much of it is actually now open? Allahu A'lam. But the point is, when it's finally opened and Ya'juj and Ma'juj are able to come out, it'll be the time when Allah has decreed and they will come out. And this is the way it will happen when the day comes. First of all, Ya'juj and Ma'juj are unable to get out of there. Number one, there are many reasons why. Number one, as we said before, they are a very primitive people. Their understanding of technology is not like ours. They don't know what's going on in the world right now. They don't have computers, they don't have airplanes, they don't have these weaponry we have. They have nothing. Remember the people who said to Dhulqarnain, please protect us from them, and they were primitive themselves. Well, Ya'juj and Ma'juj are even more primitive than them. So they don't have the idea of technology of how to, you know, break through this wall. And they are between mountains. These mountains are covered with such bad climate that if they try to go up these mountains, they'll die. So they can't go around or on top of this wall. Some people said this wall is the Great Wall of China. No, it's not the Great Wall of China. For the Great Wall of China is broken. You can easily pass through it, and on top of it, it's a tourist site. Ya'juj and Ma'juj are not behind the Wall of China, nor are they the Chinese people. A lot of people, they say, oh, they're the Chinese people. And some people, they describe them as being short, you know, they're like midgets walking around, and they've got these strange eyes, and this is all rubbish, you know. There's nothing in the hadith that states that they are like that, like aliens or something. They are real human beings from the upper part of the world. They have a certain look, maybe more of an Asian look because it's that region, or more of that type of a look, Allahu A'lam. But the point is, they are people, they are humans like you and us, but they are just very, very corruptive. They are more corruptive than the corruptive people of today. Immoral. No principles, nothing. And when they come out, they just destroy. They destroy, rob, rape, kill, murder, all of these things. And they just worry about, they want to be the leaders of the world. They want to be the power, but in a very, you know, they're like gangsters, but the worst of gangsters, like thugs, the worst of thugs ever seen, ever known.